Welcome back, guys. Today we're joined by Alex from Gigabyte, and he's brought in the new Gigabyte Z690 motherboard to show us and these two builds. So, Alex, what have you got for us?
Yeah, cheers for having me. I'm very excited to be here to talk about the latest Z690 motherboards from Gigabyte, and I've also brought along these two systems just so we can showcase the motherboards being used as well.
Alrighty, Alex, so you brought in these two cool builds for us, and this one's obviously really caught my eye, so can you tell us a little bit more about it?
Yeah, sure thing. So I've actually put this one together myself. It was put together when Z690 sort of after it was released around December last year, and I've put this one together for the new Matrix movie. It was a campaign that we were running at the time, hence all the green and black theming, and it's actually a UV reactive system. Doesn't have much lighting inside it. That's because I've purposely made it that way. So if you shine some nice UV lighting on it in the dark, it'll really glow nicely.
Yeah, nice. I can see a little bit of light here. You've sold me on the design itself, but what about like the system, the specs?
Yeah, so that one's running our Z690 AORUS Master. So it's one of our main price to performance motherboards in the Z690 range. It's got an i9-12900K, so it's really good for overclocking on that motherboard. It's got an RTX 3080. It's got 32 gigs of our new DDR5 RAM as well, and 1 terabyte of storage.
Yeah, nice. And remember this little cute one over here?
Yeah, so we've also brought a more basic system to sort of contrast that crazy one over there. This one's running a B660 motherboard, so it's running our B660M AORUS Pro AX, so it's an MATX system, so it's a bit smaller. And also, if you're looking just to gaming, good performance out of the box, you're not looking to overclock or anything like that, then B660 will do the job for you as well.
All right, so we haven't seen a Z690 motherboard on the channel, Alex, so you get to be the first to tell us about it. The first thing I noticed, obviously covered in Armour in the board, which obviously looks cool, and I think 19 VRMs on this board here.
Yeah, so I guess we'll talk about the VRM first. So with Z690, we've actually built some of the strongest VRM we've ever put together on a motherboard before. You've got up to 20 phases of power, 105 amps each phase. So that's on the higher end extreme motherboards. This is the Z690 AORUS Master. This one's actually got 19 phases of power. Usually the Master is the best price to performance motherboard that's aimed at enthusiasts. So with this one, you'll definitely be able to push the latest 12th gen 12900K CPU to its limits in terms of overclocking.
That's what we want to hear. And what about these two boards on the side here?
So these two boards are more of our mid-range Z690 AORUS Pro. So if you're after really good performance out of the box, then these ones definitely the ones for you. And then in terms of VRMs, they've got 16 phases of power. Similar design actually on all of our ATX Z690 motherboards. So that goes pretty much across the board in terms of both AORUS and Gigabyte motherboards. You'll get the 16 phases of power minimum.
Just going back to the armor plating I mentioned at the start, is this going to like protect me mid-battle, bit of fire resistance, you know?
Yeah, well, I don't know if it's going to give much fire resistance, but in terms of keeping those VRM temperatures cool, when you're overclocking that i9-12900K CPU, I think it's definitely going to do the job for that. So with Z690, we've actually improved on some of our latest cooling technologies. So the main one will be the FinArray 3. So that's the third generation of our FinArray heatsink design for VRM. And you can see that on the master here. So with the FinArray heatsink, it's usually a lot better in terms of cooling efficiency when you compare that to like more of a chunkier heatsink like that. And then on top of that, we've also improved on the direct touch heat pipe that's underneath. So underneath the heatsink, you've got a copper heat pipe that runs through there. We've actually increased the size of that, and that comes into direct contact with the VRMs underneath to further help improve that cooling performance.
Yeah, nice. And down the bottom here, I think this is where the M.2s live, even more armor.
Yep, so for the M.2s, we've got more thermal armor. So the way that works is the M.2 sort of gets sandwiched in there. So you can see the main heatsink here, you've got a bigger one on the master. So once you take that off, if you've got an M.2 that's already got a heatsink on it, then you have to take that off, but it's got a plate at the bottom. You stick that on there, then you've got the armor on top, and then it sort of cools it from both sides. Because some M.2 SSDs will actually have the memory modules on both sides as well.
Yeah, nice. And this little nice paint job here, this is something special as well?
That's right. So that's a good pointing out that one. So with that, we've got actually what it's called a nano carbon coating. So that's included on all of the motherboards, on pretty much all of the cooling components. And yeah, that's basically what you can see on the heatsink here. And with the nanocarbon coating, that further improves the heat performance by another 10% or so.
They've got like obviously a really similar design. The whole bottom half is almost looks exactly the same. Up the top here with the fins, I can tell there's a bit of a difference between the heatsinks. So this is obviously the master and these are both pros, but is there like a reason you bought in two pros to show us?
Yes, that's actually a really good question because yep, they are pretty much identical, these two motherboards. The main difference between them is that one will feature DDR4 memory and this one will feature DDR5. So actually with the Z690 motherboards, the master and above will feature DDR5 only. Everything else below that, so the Pro, the Ultra, all of our other either AORUS or Gigabyte motherboards from the Z690 range, you'll be able to choose between both DDR4 and DDR5 options.
It sounds really good. Is there any like, you know, special features to these Gigabyte boards that, you know, that might help the RAM that we can't see?
Yep, so in terms of a unique feature to our memory design is the SMT DIMM, and with that you've got the shortest memory routing possible from the CPU to the memory slots themselves. And also we've got another feature called shielded memory routing, which actually hides all of the memory traces underneath that PCB layer, provides a much better power efficiency from the CPU to the memory. And on top of that, we've got the special Armour plating, which is the stainless steel Armour around the actual DIMM slots on the RAM as well. So with that, it provides much better durability in terms of, you know, plugging in your RAM.
Nice. So we've talked about, you know, the extra VRMs, all the Armour plating, DDR4, DDR5. So any other like features about the board you want to tell us?
Yes, that's a good question actually. With Z690, we're actually introducing PCIe 5.0 with these motherboards.
Yeah, nice. So what does like 5.0 do for us today?
Yep, so in terms of PCIe 5.0, I guess the main benefit at the moment is that it's allowing motherboard makers to sort of balance the bandwidth that's offered from all the chipset and the CPU lanes. So with that, I guess you can get more bandwidth on your M.2. More bandwidth for Ethernet ports and things like that, more USB, SATA, things like that. So sort of it allows motherboard makers to balance the bandwidth out, and then I guess it also gives it an option for future proofing down the line when you get more improved graphics cards using PCIe 5.0 or PCIe 5.0 M.2s and things like that.
Yeah, nice. Sounds like a bit of overall better connectivity as well then with the larger bandwidth?
Yep, so with Z690 you actually do get a lot more USB ports. Actually all of the USB ports on our motherboards will feature USB 3.2 Gen 2x2, so that's 20 gigabits per second USB. With that you also get Thunderbolt 4 available on most of our motherboards. In terms of Ethernet, you've got 2.5 gigabit Ethernet as standard, and then with that you've also got Wi-Fi 6E, which is the latest Wi-Fi standard from Intel as well.
Lovely. So we've gone over the Z690 motherboards in a lot of detail. They seem pretty awesome. And at the start, we had a little cute small PC with us, and you said it was a B660 in it, and I noticed it had a 12th gen processor in it. So I can tell obviously same socket, 12th gen. Is there much difference between the B660 and the Z690?
Yes, that's a good question. So yeah, the newer 12th gen CPUs will work on the B660 and the Z690 chipset as well. So the main difference between those two chipsets, I guess the main difference will be the overclocking capabilities. So you can get the unlocked K-SKU CPUs for the Z690 motherboards and you can overclock the CPU, whereas on B660 you don't have that option. You can still do memory overclocking on B660, but not CPU. And then further from that, you've got less bandwidth coming from the CPU and from the chipset with B660. So with that you have, you know, fewer PCIe lanes and things like that, so you can't do dual graphics cards, you have fewer USB, fewer SATA, things like that. So if you're running less devices, you're not interested in overclocking, you're only doing one graphics card, then yeah, B660 will be a really good system option as well. For those that want, you know, really good performance out of the box, even with a 3080 or a 3080 Ti, just basically a nice plug and play solution.
Alrighty guys, that's all we have time for today. So we've gone over a lot with the two builds and all the motherboards. So I want to say a big thank you to Alex for bringing them in for us.
Yeah, cheers. Thanks a lot for having me here. It was a really good pleasure and I hope you guys learned something new about our Z690 motherboards. And if you want to check out more on these two builds, we'll have the links in the description so you guys can check out the build videos as well.
Awesome. Alrighty guys, hope you're all having a wonderful day and I will see you all next time.